Teams both look to push the tempo and transition. Brent, what's the most underrated component of success with that style of play, you think?
You got to have committed runners, BA. That's the huge part about transition. If a guy has the ball, the best he can be is having options, not just to go score himself, but to find guys who are willing to run the court with him.
So the Hornets starting five. Washington is the four, and Zeller at center. Terry Rozier is out there with ball, and it's Hayward in at the three slot. Here's Golden State. Outside Curry. Pass to Wiggins. Green with a screen on Rozier. Good.
Yeah, that's just working for the better shot. We always talk about in the NBA, good to great, great possession there.
Washington with the ball to the left side wing. Now Rozier. Back to Washington. Just five on the clock. And it's out of bounds to the Hornets as Charlotte retains possession. And now just over a minute played here in the first. Hayward's shot is off. And here are the Warriors now. Last time they came together was in Charlotte, where they fell to the Hornets.
Just a tough road loss. You're going against players who are comfortable shooting in their own building. You have to find a way to disrupt their focus.
Yeah, they couldn't do it in that one. Always a step slow in closing out the shooters and maybe even recognition of who was on the floor. Just not enough energy, and that's a tough way to win on the road.
Off on the first. And the second free throw is good. First quarter of play with about a minute and a half gone by. Wiggins outside, back to Curry. Shoots over ball, and the basket by Curry.
Defensively, you can't afford to get stuck on the pick.
That's one that the coaches will watch tomorrow with that player. You hate to see him give up in that situation.
What a fast break for the Warriors.
In transition, Oubre will feast on those kind of opportunities, quick to the rim.
And around 2 minutes played here in the first quarter. There's the steal. Pass to Curry. Hayward with a steal. Here's Zeller. Rozier, left side. Now here's Hayward. Clock at six. Gets a hand on it. Oh, he hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
Well, a missed box out and an easy tip in, but it's because of the activity as the ball is going up, finding yourself in the right spot, just using some effort.
The three from Curry. He can't hit that time. So the Hornets will take it the other way, fresh off a win against the Warriors.
They were lights out from beyond the arc, and they spaced the floor beautifully in that one.
Yep, made the defense work extremely hard and did a nice job of getting any advantage they could against the team that shot it well.
Now here's Zeller. Another shot. Drops in the layup for two. Zeller's got his second bucket on the night.
Offensive rebounding is all about wanting it. Fantastic effort there, leading to second chance points.
High expectations. Grant, a former top five pick, Cody Zeller has really become more of a valuable role player now.
You know, B.A., what's fascinating is that scouts saw him as a mobile big with a terrific jump shot. Now, he may have reached his ceiling on the earlier side of his career, but now, instead of being your first or second option on offense, he's a guy who prides himself on making all the hustle plays.
Well, that successful physicality on Oubre's part, not afraid to get right up in the shooter's business.
Defense doesn't get much better than the mobile one block we just saw on replay.
Early in a game, these sorts of plays really can set the tone.
Pascal, he's checked in for the Warriors. And the Hornets making a change here as well. Bridges, he's checked in for Hayward. Here's Washington. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one.
Just great offense. The screen freeing him up for the slam.
Hey, without that screen, he doesn't get a clean look at the rim.
Yeah, why settle for the layup when you can attack the rim and rise up like that?
Now here's Curry. They trail by one.
Yeah, he's not very hard to defend right now. This is when the defense might step back and let him try to find his range.
Kept alive by Charlotte. Bridges outside. Screen by Zeller. And finally, they hit one. Zeller's got six.
Timeout.
And they may have talked about shot selection coming into this.
And some changes here for the Warriors. Bazemore's checked in for Oubre. Lee comes in for Wiggins. And it's Wanamaker in for Stephen Curry. Well, Grant, as you watch the league since you retired, what has been the biggest change in your mind?
Yeah, B.A., there's been a number of changes. But one change that I think that really stands out, of course, is this idea of load management. You know, teams think big picture with players. And now when guys get hurt or if guys are nursing injuries from years past, there's this notion that we have to manage the season and every game is not of importance. But what's important is the health and safety of players throughout the course of their career. And I'll tell you what,
take a break.
I think I would have benefited greatly with this sort of new NBA and emphasis on player rest.
The first one falls. So he gets them both.
And you can tell he's feeling confident right now at the line, and when he's on, he can be lights out.
Here's Martin. Pass to Martin. Six on the shot clock. It's rebounded by Golden State. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Hornets.
In this league, you have to stay active at both ends of the floor. I thought their lackluster defense was the difference in the game.
Well, you can't allow any opponent to shoot that kind of percentage. If you do, it's just going to be so tough to keep up.
Here's Martin. The floater. And the layup is good.
When a player gets a feel for that floater, it can really make things tough on defenders. You're just not sure how to guard them and where your point of commitment is.
Pass to Wanamaker. Outside Pascal. Here's Wanamaker. Gets the three to fall.
Pretty much not a player in the league is going to pass up a shot like that, so much for the defense.
Here's Martin. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Here's Martin. Bridges outside. Rebounded by Green. The Warriors have gone 5 of 9 from the floor. Here's Wanamaker. 14 points for him last game against the Hornets in Charlotte.
And guys, in addition to that scoring, he was absolutely tenacious on the defensive end. A complete two-way game for him. Finished with 3 steals, I think, and that was a difference maker.
Outside Graham. The 3. The shot no good. 1 quarter in the books, and it's been a close one. Warriors ahead. They're up by 3. Quarter number 2 coming up right after this break. Don't go anywhere. And we asked Steph Curry, a great self-motivator in his own right, who holds you to the highest standard? Here's what he had to say.
Oh, my wife, for sure. No, never everyone disappoint her. She shoots it to me straight. That's the biggest thing, whether I play well or not. I don't get too big of a head, or I don't feel too down on myself either.
Ah, smart man. The home life definitely supporting a legendary career.
And Steph has already put up Hall of Fame numbers, but you can tell he doesn't feel anywhere near finished.
Man, some good action in the books as we get back to a game that's been pretty close so far here. And from what we've seen here from the Warriors, what's your take so far?
Well, you have to credit their effort on the defensive end. It set the tone for this contest.
Yeah, defense has been infectious here as everybody stepping up aggressively on that end.
They've got Eric Paschal. Stephen Curry is out there with Andrew Wiggins. Then there's Kelly Oubre, and it's Toscano in at the power forward position. That's the Warriors 5. He misses the free throw.
Something about Paschal and his effort and his motor. There had to have been something from his time as a collegiate player at Villanova that the Warriors really liked in terms of what they were going to get consistently from Eric.
He hits the 2nd from the line. Well, just as he was in college, Paschal has proven to be a valuable glue guy who does all the little things, Brent.
And he appreciates that role, B.A., and that's what's awesome about it. He's playing alongside some of the most super of superstars in the league, and he's excited about that opportunity to grow as a player.
And keeping us updated from the sideline, Allie LaForce.
Well, the Hornets are going young. Coach James Borrego said, quote, "The way we're building this is to compete. It's important for our guys to understand that it starts on the defensive end for us. We are turning the corner. I think a lot of it has to do with the length and athleticism we have on the floor." Brian?
Man, I'd agree with that. Thanks, Allie. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair. Grant, you were an exceptional ball handler in your day. How about now? Who's the best scorer off the bounce in this league?
You know, B.A., you would give me that tough question. I mean, that's with all the great players in this league who are all very capable off the bounce. I don't know. I probably would have to go with James Harden. I mean, his ability on the perimeter, handling the basketball, step back three-pointers, and then, of course, he's so good and crafty with the ball, getting to the basket, drawing fouls. You know what? The MVP of the league in years past, I'd have to say it's James Harden.
I'm just going to throw in LeBron James on you for a moment, and maybe a little hint of Luka Magic as well.
Yeah, they're pretty good, too. That's fair.
And he sinks the 2nd. The Warriors leading. And here's Curry, a dangerous offensive player. His scoring average stands at almost 30 a game. The kick out to Wiggins. Pass to Paschal. The 3 from Curry. Got it. 2 for 5 now.
The consistency from the distance that Steph shoots at, I think, is one of the more astounding parts of his accuracy from the three-point line.
Now here's Ball. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game from him. And he makes it.
one of the more skilled offensive players that is on the floor here tonight. Not an easy fella to hold in check.
Ball against Curry. And the Warriors with another three.
Yeah, that first quarter was a bit shaky. Good to see a player who doesn't let a slow start get to him.
Zeller up top. Shot from 12. The shot no good. And Golden State will go the other way with it. Outside Curry. The three. That won't go either for Curry.
He didn't make them pay for that weak defense, but they just can't rely on him to miss those kind of shots.
Hayward. Oh, a clear foul there on the missed shot. So he'll get a pair at the line.
The tenacious competitor. Hayward is more than comfortable playing in attack mode.
Free throw good from Hayward. Both free throws good from Hayward.
Getting themselves to the line this quarter is a good way to get their offense rolling.
Golden State has got 4 of 7 threes to go so far in this game. Curry with it. Give him 8. Driving to the basket. Pass to Pascal. Back to Wiggins. 6 to shoot. Pascal, a screen on Hayward. Second chance shot. And there's the rejection. Nice shot by Pascal. All right, for those just joining us, we're almost 2.5 minutes into the second. It's Hayward on the wing. Here's Zeller. Pascal defends. Back to Hayward. Screen by Zeller. Sinks that one from the post. Hayward's got 8.
Defensively, you can't afford to get stuck on the pick.
That's one that the coaches will watch tomorrow with that player. You hate to see him give up in that situation.
Now here's Wiggins. He's coming off a 19-point game against Charlotte. That one a little long.
If you told me this was the kind of game he was going to have, I would not have expected them to be in front right now.
Washington, right side. Now here's Hayward. He's closely guarded. It's not going to go for him. The Warriors have gone 3 for 7 here in the second quarter. Outside Oubre. Back to Curry. Let's go with a three. Sends it home from three-point land. He's got 11.
Well, Oubre will draw some attention as a scorer, but that's going to open up some passing lanes, and he doesn't make a mistake that time.
Washington bearing his second of 3 attempts.
Hey, they're just getting pushed around inside.
Golden State has gone 3 of 4 from outside so far in the second quarter. Outside Curry. Over Ball. That won't go either for Curry.
The D giving him that shot, and that's probably not a good idea, but I guess they knew what they were doing that time.
Ball outside. Shot clock at 6. Here's Toscano. Boy, no scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Curry against Rozier. Shot is good by Curry. And the Warriors lead by 8.
Just how awesome is it to watch the best of the best start to dominate in a game?
You know, Brent, now he's entering his mid-30s. What do you think may change with Stephen's game, if anything?
I think he's just going to fall off the cliff. Yeah. I'm kidding. Obviously, this guy is one of the greatest shooters of all time. And they say that you get better as a shooter as you get older. Is that humanly possible with Steph Curry? I don't think so.
and a new group getting ready for the Warriors. Green's checked in for Pascal. Bazemore comes in for Oubre. Lee, he's checked in for Wiggins. And it's Wanamaker in for Curry. Okay, Grant, in 1999, you joined Wilt Chamberlain and Elgin Baylor as the only players to have led their teams in points, rebounds, and assists more than once. Talk about what it feels like to be mentioned with those guys.
Wow. B.A., I really didn't know that, so thank you for telling me. That is rarefied air to be in the same category and mentioned in the same breath as the great Wilt Chamberlain and Elgin Baylor. I tell you, it humbles you. You know, in 1999, I just felt like I needed to get better to try to help my team become a championship-quality team. And to look back on that over 20 years later and to know that from an individual standpoint, I was producing alongside some of the greats to ever play the game.
Though Graham may lack some height, he has a plus wingspan, and he is strong, Graham.
And he's a really good athlete, too, B.A. The physical tools are all there. But where he really separates himself, it's that basketball IQ. He reads the floor exceptionally well and knows how to execute.
No good on the free throw. He's good on the second. The Warriors have gotten five of their first 11 shots to fall here in the second quarter. Here's Wanamaker. Graham covering. Charlotte trailing. We've got 1:23 left in the second. And the basket by Bridges. Bridges has gotten his first points in this one.
His nimbleness makes him a unique threat at the rim.
Outside, Green. Here's Bazemore. Well, he hasn't scored yet, but I'm sure that'll change. Pass to Green. Golden State needs to get off a shot. For three. It's rebounded by Charlotte.
And you never want to give a shooter like him a clean look.
Now here's Biyombo. And here's Graham. Wanamaker grabs the miss.
Now that's how to protect the rim without fouling. Force him into an awkward release and a bit of an adjustment on the layup.
Here's Wanamaker. And he lays it up and in. Wanamaker's got 7 points.
Coaching staff would like some more shots from that range.
Now here's Graham. Launches it. No good. Misses at the buzzer. And the first half comes to an end. We've got a close game going here. Warriors ahead, up 5. We'll see you after halftime for the beginning of the third quarter.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Welcome back, everybody. SRO, standing room only.
Ooh, nice.
I'm your host, Ernie Johnson. Got Shaq here. Got Kenny the Jet. And Shaq, so many fans know Steph for the deep threes, but Curry is also one of the league's more efficient scorers.
Yeah, career 47% shooter from the field. Hits over 50% from the field one season, which he took 900 triples.
Wow.
Insane.
That is. He's just, you know, he was a 3-star recruit coming out of high school. Like, no one thought he was going to be a great player. No one's worked harder on his skill set. And Steph, who's now won multiple MVPs, has shut up the critics.
And it's just about time now for the third quarter to get underway.
Steph Second half of basketball is upon us, and we may be in for an exciting finish based on how close of a game we've seen so far. Man, it's been quite a game for Stephen Curry.
Through the first two quarters and change, his perimeter shooting continues to be spot on.
Yeah, you would hope the defense at least would start to consider creeping up on him just a little bit.
And after a fairly even first couple of quarters, this second half could turn out to be a great one, as both teams trying to gain an edge. And so in the game for the Hornets, Washington is the four and Zeller at center. Terry Rozier is out there with ball, and it's Hayward in at the three, a small forward. Now here's Curry. He's got 13. Just five to shoot. And there's the drive. Uses the glass on the layup. Curry's got 15 points.
Well, the kitchen is open. Chef Curry's getting it done right now. And, man, on fire.
Washington outside. Hayward outside. From deep. And the rebound goes to the Warriors. The three is up, and Curry is good for three. Curry's got 5 points now this quarter.
Things are starting to come together for them, and the lead is starting to grow, too.
Coaches always talk about the first 5 minutes of the third quarter. They have definitely increased their energy level here.
Now here's Hayward. Give him eight, and out of bounds. The Warriors will take it. And now another look at that mobile one block defensive performance.
And that's exactly what a team needs when they're trailing. Energy on the defensive side of the ball.
And with a little over a minute gone by, the second half is underway. Now Wiggins. He's been an offensive weapon for them, scoring around 17 and a half points a game. Outside Curry. Off target from outside.
Man, that's his shot. Maybe he was too wide open.
Pass to Washington. Zeller high post. Ball outside. This one for three. But they recover it. Again the miss by the Hornets. Golden State has gone 6 for 12 from deep so far in this game. Ball against Curry. Driving in. And he comes up with a bucket. Curry's got 20 points.
Yeah, so just a shooter? I don't think so.
For Charlotte, they've gone 0 for 4. Not the way they want to start the second half. Boy, one area where Curry often doesn't get enough credit, Grant, his effort on defense.
You know, B.A., he really does try on the defensive end. And he can be very effective against players his size. But he also brings that fight to bigger players, even when they try to post him up. Curry has heart, and he takes the challenge seriously.
Here's Hayward. After the Warriors picking up a basket just a moment ago. And Grant, you won two college titles at Duke, a Hall of Fame NBA career. Now, does it bother you that you never won an NBA title? Be truthful.
Yeah, man, you would bring that up. B.A., it definitely bothers me. I played 19 years in the NBA and never got a chance to play on that stage in the NBA Finals, let alone win an NBA title. Having tasted what it's like to be a champion twice in college and with USA in 1996, one of my big regrets was never having that opportunity to experience that on the NBA level.
And the Warriors making a change here. Pascal's checked in. Both free throws good from Hayward. And here's Wiggins. Pass to Green. Outside Pascal. Here's Curry. That one off the back iron and out. Charlotte has got nothing to fall here in the third. 0 for 4. Ball outside. Wiggins against Rozier. And it's blocked. They recover it. Here's Hayward. No good on the shot. Good work defensively by Oubre. The three from Curry knocks down the long J. Curry's got 12 points here in the second half.
Well, he's building off that strong first half he had. I'm not sure the defense will be able to figure him out in the second.
Time called here. The Hornets decide to talk it over. Man, it's been quite a game for Stephen Curry.
The defense has to take the ball out of his hands. He's just knocking down every three-pointer he takes right now.
Pass to Washington. Hayward for three. Drops in the three. Hayward's got 13.
The deep shooting ability of Hayward is invaluable. A forward who stretches the D.
Here's Pascal. In the third quarter with just over 3.5 minutes off the clock, Pascal sets a screen. Curry finds Pascal. Down to five on the shot clock. Pascal, a screen on Hayward. Oubre.
Oh, yes, sir!
Oh, my!
Throw that one up top.
Oh, what a play.
Yeah, Oubre can get up. How about that one?
Zeller high post. Beyond the arc. It's hauled in by Oubre.
Well, if he's going to keep shooting, they've got to run some plays for him. Screens, pick and rolls, anything they can do to get him started.
Throughout the second half, they've achieved excellent efficiency on the offensive end.
Ball with it. Now quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket is good, and he'll go to the line.
Man, what focus. I mean, the hoop and the harm. Incredible.
Lee, he's checked in for the Warriors.
One shot.
And that one misses. And you think about the impact Draymond has had, not just on the Warriors, Grant, but on the entire league.
Draymond, by putting him at the five and being successful with it, caused many other teams to follow suit. It's such a copycat league. We saw Houston put P.J. Tucker at the five as well. Boston put Tice at the five, too. It's a major shift in the league right now.
Bridges, right side. Yes, it's good.
Well, that's how you draw it up right there. A screen to shed the defense, a quick move to the bucket, and you get the lay-in.
The three from Curry nails it from three. Curry's got 15 points here in the second half.
Pretty easy right now. Clear out, give him some space, let him get to work.
Pass to Biyombo. Back to Ball. And he throws it down with one hand.
Incredible. It sometimes falls to the point guard to be the offensive catalyst.
Seems like he always knows when his squad needs a lift.
Did you see how much air he had under him? Wow.
The three from Curry. Another three for Golden State.
This defense just can't stay connected to shooters.
Charlotte is gone. 1 of 6 from three-point range here in the third. Not the result they're looking for. Okay, a chance to look at some numbers for Terry Rozier. Golden State has gotten 12 of their points this quarter from deep, 4 of 6. Curry against Graham. Count it. Curry's got 33.
This looks like he's got more feel tonight, like he's really got a good grip on that ball as he's letting it go.
Pass to Bridges. To the wing on the left. There's 47 seconds left to play in the third quarter of basketball. He shoots. Graham misses. And the Warriors shooting a fantastic 57%. Here's Curry. Here's Pascal. And that's a foul called on Stephen Curry. That'll be a second foul of the game. The Hornets making a switch here. The Hornets shooting about 31% here in quarter number three. Shot from 12. And the shot no good. A bit short.
Hate to say it, but if they're still trailing at the final buzzer, a lot of this is going to be felt by him. His shooting tonight has just been atrocious.
Pascal can't hit. And here at the end of the third, it's a double-digit ball game. Warriors ahead. They lead by 18. And we're just moments away from the start of quarter number four. Stay with us. Been two very different performances from these teams today as we get going in quarter number four. Charlotte is shooting just around 34% in this game so far. They've got Andrew Wiggins, and it's Pascal in at the center position. That's the Warriors five. Here's Rozier. Count it. Good. Rozier's got his first bucket in this one.
They have no answer defensively inside.
Wiggins outside. Here's Poole, pounded by Rozier. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So two free throws for him coming up. It's going to go on Cody Zeller. That one misses. Wanamaker, he's checked in for Bazemore. Good on the second one. Here's Rozier. Pass to Martin. Washington, left side. And he drives in. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And he knocks down the first one. And so he hits both.
They're finding a rhythm from the line as they try to cut into this deficit.
Here's Wanamaker, guarded by Hayward. 60 ticks off the clock here in the fourth. Here's Wanamaker, guarded by Hayward. 4 on the clock. Poole's shot is off. The Hornets shooting just around 36%. Not the best execution. Pass to Martin. Hayward outside. Count that one.
A staple of Hayward's offensive arsenal. Give him room to fire from there, and he'll take it.
Here's Wiggins. Hornets with the rebound.
I think he rushed that one just a little bit, thinking the defense was going to get close. They weren't.
To the paint. Here's Zeller. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take 2 free throws.
I don't mind that. I mean, they met him at the rim and temporarily prevented the points.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
That free throw, no good. And some changes here for the Warriors. Green comes in for Pascal. And it's Oubre in for Wanamaker. And a change for the Hornets. Ball's checked in. And he's good on the second. And we're about 2 minutes into the fourth now. Here's Poole. Pass to Toscano. Back to Wiggins. 4-3. The offensive rebound. Let's the 3 fly. The shot, no good.
Well, there's more he could have done in this game for sure, but it hasn't kept them from pulling ahead.
Here's Rozier. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Rozier's got 4 points in the quarter.
They've still got work to do, but it's impressive how they've battled back.
Finally got themselves in the trenches. Momentum completely shifted now. We've got a tight one here in the final period.
Now here's Oubre. Green, a screen. Now here's Ball. From the arc. And Toscano pulls it down. Golden State has gone 0-for-2 from outside here in the fourth quarter. Here's Poole, hounded by Ball. Poole's shot is off. The Hornets have gone 3-of-5 since this fourth quarter started. Pass to Washington. A look at the clock. A little under 3.5 minutes gone by in the fourth. Ooh, ripped away! Here's Poole. To the middle. Here's Toscano. And he goes in for the dunk.
What a two-way play. Just tremendous.
Yeah, the steal was slick. The slam topped it off.
And we say it time and time again, so I'll repeat it. Have to be careful with the ball, or this is what happens.
Now here's Ball. Now Zeller. 6 to shoot. Hayward for 3. Sinks the tray. Hayward's got 10 points in just the second half.
This is anyone's game now, and they have the momentum.
Yeah, this is not the team that we saw in the first quarter right now. Way more confident out there, and the cohesion of the team is impressive.
Here's Green. Stolen by Ball. Inside. Knocked loose. It's stolen by Green. Here's Poole. Hounded by Ball. And that one drops. And the Warriors lead by 11. Charlotte has gone 1-for-2 from deep in this fourth quarter. Oubre against Hayward. Unable to get that one. Good work defensively by Oubre. Pass to Wiggins. Fader on the way. He's off on that one. So the Hornets will take it the other way. Ball into the lane. Green with the defensive effort. The Warriors shooting it well. Almost 50% from the floor. And here's Wiggins. Into the lane. And down it goes. Jam that one home.
A mobile attacking player. Wiggins' teammates and coaches love when he uses his physical tools to his advantage.
Hayward with it. A minute 20 left in the fourth quarter. Here's Poole. Shoots over ball. Tried to bank it in, but it misses. The Hornets have gotten 4 of 9 shots to go in during this fourth quarter.
And they had an advantage tonight. Came out sharp and did what was needed. Nice win here for the Warriors.
They looked to run anytime they could.
They set the tone with their pace. Their transition game was excellent.
And here are the Warriors now. The Hornets making their last shot. Stolen by Rozier. Fires the three. Here's Zeller. And there's contact and a whistle. So he's got two shots coming up. And there's the call. Golden State with the foul.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
Good on the first, and that brings him within 10. And the Warriors going with a whole new group out there. Good on both. Here's Pascal. Pass to Wanamaker. The shot that time, not on target. From deep three-point range, and it's Monk missing.
It's never easy from that distance, but we see him drill those and shoot around all the time.
Oh, no, I know he can make it, but that's warm-ups, so maybe just a step too far.
And so the Warriors take the win. This one was a fun one to watch. They were clearly in the driver's seat down the stretch.
They really were, B.A. They played with great intensity on both ends of the floor, and they didn't allow their mistakes to get the better of them.
And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Ali LaForce, Brent Berry, Grant Hill, and our entire 2K Sports crew, this is Brian Anderson signing off. So long, everyone.